that it is yours. It is just not for us to learn the thesis of Holy Spirit. It's for you to experience that it's practical, it's alive, and it's on you. And that power, it's within you. It's there for you to use it. Not there for you just to know. It's there for you to use it.
And the Bible says they were very diligent in their prayer.
Amen.
Very diligent. Mama Kutu, very diligent with their prayer. Not only that, the persevere. They move from one level to another level. When it's not arrived on the second day, third day, fourth day, 10th day, 20th day, they continue, they persevere. Not only diligent, they persevere.
Amen.
And also, not only persevere, there was a unity. They were in one accord.
Amen.
They were in one accord. See, Christian today, if we want to experience the outpouring of the Holy Spirit in our service, we need to come in one accord. That's why when we sing a chorus and we continue to sing the same chorus, then our hearts start to come together, binded together.
Hallelujah.
Binded together. Then Holy Spirit comes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So not only in one accord, that is unity and agreement, but also in one place. We are not in one place, but we are in one platform.
See? Amen.
You can be from Lau, watching from Matuku, watching from Totoya, or
right
from
Manila,
or in America, or in Europe, or in Germany, or in Thailand, or in Bangkok. I want to tell you, because of this platform, we are like at one place.
Amen.
The beauty of one place.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And those are the conditions of his visitation.
Amen.
Hallelujah. On this day, we talk about when he arrives.
Amen.
Hallelujah. When he arrives, another seven lesson. It just happened to be 777. Hallelujah. The Bible says the manifestation when the Holy Spirit come to our service. Hallelujah. Number one, there will be a sound. There will be excitement.
Hallelujah.
You are singing. No, you don't worry about the tune, the tone. You just worry about just telling God.
Yeah.
You sing with joy, with open heart.
When the Holy Spirit is there, you are noisy. Yes. You are saying, hallelujah,
hallelujah,
praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Amen.
You are not quiet.
You are not keeping still.
You are so filled up with the fire of God within you.
Yes.
And that fire is that heat from the Holy
Who
Spirit.
Who said that?
Oh, hallelujah.
Is quiet.
Yeah.
So that's why when the new church arrived to Fiji, the Pentecostal movement, people say, oh, the church is very noisy.
Yeah,
no.
Very irritatingly noisy.
And sometimes they call the police. Hallelujah. But when the noise of the singing ring and the noise of other sound, nobody called the police. Because this noise touched the heavenly realm.
Oh, hallelujah.
And the devil doesn't like that noise. Because that noise is the fire of the Holy Spirit.
Yeah, even for a long drive, if you're going with your family, sing out.
Hallelujah.
Sing out. You know, when you sing, it's amazing. Because when you continue to sing, you continue to sing. And the longer the drive, the powerful presence of the Holy Spirit will manifest inside the car. I know what it feels. I mean, we drive down to Nandia and Suva. When I was working in Gaselebu, was already here on full time. That is my route. And it's just singing. It's you sing, pray, cry. It's such a good feeling. Just to experience him. Because when he's there, you don't know what else to say. You just cry out. You don't know how are you crying or why you're crying, but you're just crying because his presence is there and it comes on you like a fire. You feel so heated up. There's something there that you cannot explain, and that is the power of the Holy Spirit. Or sometimes when you're singing, praising God in the worship center or in the zone, or when you come together to worship him, you cannot hold you. I mean, you just continue to scream and raise your hand, or even when you stand at the altar, you continue to lift his name and glorify him. That's the power of the Holy Spirit. You need to allow your body and allow your spirit and allow your soul to rejoice and bring glory to this God.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Because of that noise. Hallelujah. Because when he arrives, you will feel the presence of the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
So you couldn't care less of the noise. Hallelujah. I used to remember when we have our devotion. Lekela is only 7 months or
nine months now.
So when we sing, she will be clapping and she will be just
making
shouting,
sound like she wants
making
to
sound.
Sing.
And she's only 8 and 9 months now. Hallelujah. But she wants to join in. Why? The Holy Spirit. And sometimes she'll be just stepping the floor. And she's only 9 months. Who said that you come to church and be quiet? No, that happens in your quiet time. That's why they call it the quiet time. But when we come together as believer, you will feel, hallelujah,
oh, hallelujah.
The joy of the Lord is our strength. Hallelujah. Not only that, because the Bible says, it sound the noise in the prayer room was like a mighty rushing wind. There was no wind, but the noise created.
Hallelujah.
And number two, on this manifestation of his arrival.